Good morning children, we are continuing fractions and decimals. So far we did addition, subtractions, multiplications in fractions and I introduced divisions also. Now we are going to understand how to divide a whole number with a fraction or a fraction with a whole number. That we are going to understand today. So chapter 2. Fractions and decimals. Today's date is 15/07/20. So we are continuing fractions and decimals. Divide 3 with 1/4. A whole number is divided with a fraction 1/4. That means 3 is a whole number. That means there are 3 fruits, for example. You are dividing each fruit into 1/4 equal part. How many 1/4 equal parts are there in the whole 3? That we are going to understand. So solution. So first I draw a circle. Say for example this is a fruit which is divided into 4 parts. So each part is 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4. Again I took another fruit, which is again divided into 4 equal parts. 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4. Again the third fruit is divided into 4 equal parts. Each part is again 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4.
If you observe, there are 3 fruits which are divided into 1/4 equal parts. Each fruit is divided into 1/4 equal parts. How many parts totally we have? You observe how many 1/4s are there. Here we have 4 1/4s. 1/4 + 1/4 + 1/4 + 1/4. Again here we have plus 1/4 + 1/4 + 1/4 + 1/4. Again this is divided into 4 equal parts. 1/4 + 1/4 + 1/4 + 1/4. In all these fractions, the denominator is the same. So you add all the numerators. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 ones are there. So 12/4. So it is divided into 12 1/4s. So there are 12 parts. 12 equal parts of 1/4. 12 equal parts of 1/4. How you get that 12? From the division part, 3 divided by 1/4 can also be written as 3 × 4/1. It is equal to 12. There are 12 equal parts of 1/4. A whole is divided into 1/4 equal part. Suppose you write 1/3. A whole is divided into 1/3 equal parts. So here there are 3 holes which is divided into 1/4 equal part and the total number of parts is equal to 12. So instead of division, we are making use of multiplication. What is this 1/4? It is a fraction. When you divide 3 with 1/4, it is nothing but multiplying the 3 with the reciprocal of 1/4. 1/4 is the fraction. Its reciprocal is 4/1. We do one more. 5 divided by 1/6. 5 holes is divided into 1/6 equal parts. How many equal parts are there? 1/6 equal parts are there in 5 holes. This we can get as first step is 5 divided by 1/6 is equal to 5. The reciprocal of division is multiplication. 5 × 1/6 can be written as 6/1. So how many equal parts of 1/6 are there in 5 holes? There are 30 equal parts of 1/6 are there in 5 holes. 5 is a whole number. 5 holes, that means 5 objects are there. 5 objects are there. So suppose you have 5 chocolates. At the rate of 1/6, For how many persons you can divide 5 chocolates? The chocolates are bigger chocolates. So you are able to divide them among some persons. At the rate of 1 by 6, for how many persons you are going to divide 5 chocolates? You can divide 5 chocolates at the rate of 1 by 6 to 30 persons. So you got the answer as 30. 5 holes is divided into 1 by 6 equal parts. How many equal parts of 1 by 6 are there in 5 holes, which is represented by 5 divided by 1 by 6? It is nothing but 5 into 6 by 1 is equal to 30. So in the division, what we observe, there is a dividend and there is a divisor. Whenever you are dividing with a fraction, it is nothing but multiplying the dividend with the reciprocal of the divisor. Say for example, I give you a fraction, third one, 1 by 4 divided by 1 by 8. A fraction is divided by 1 by 8. Here the dividend is 1 by 4 and the divisor is 1 by 8. How many 1 by 8 parts are there in 1 fourth? That is the understanding. So I can write the first step as it is, 1 by 4 divided by 1 by 8 is equal to 1 by 4 into 8 by 1. 1 by 4 into 8 by 1. So I am writing the reciprocal of division, which is multiplication, and the reciprocal of 1 by 8 is 8 by 1. Now, 4 ones, 4 twos. Multiply the numerators, 2 into 1 it is 2, by 1 into 1 it is 1, 2 by 1 or simply it is 2. There are 2 equal parts of 1 by 8 are there in 1 by 4. So this is how we can divide a fraction with another fraction. Next. So what do you mean by reciprocal? This is very important. I told you to write reciprocal. Reciprocal of a fraction is, reciprocal of a fraction is the non-zero numbers, the non-zero numbers whose product, whose product with the given fraction, the non-zero numbers whose fraction with the given fraction, the non-zero number whose product with the given fraction is 1. Suppose you have 3 by 4. What is the reciprocal of 3 by 4? It is 4 by 3. 3 by 4 reciprocal is 4 by 3. If you multiply 3 by 4 with 4 by 3, you can observe the product equal to 1. 4, 4 gets cancelled, 3, 3 gets cancelled. So you are writing a fraction such that the given fraction and the reciprocal fraction product is always equal to 1. Then only we say it is a reciprocal of the given fraction. And it should be a non-zero number. You cannot write reciprocal for 0. So that is another important point you have to remember. There is no reciprocal for 0. This we are going to understand in rational numbers. You are going to learn that. Next. So what is the reciprocal of? Reciprocal, you understand here. Reciprocal of 4 by 5 is 5 by 4. Reciprocal of minus 7 by 8 is minus 8 by 7. Reciprocal of minus 11 by 2 is minus 2 by 11. If you have a negative fraction, its reciprocal is also negative. That is another point you have to remember. Minus 11 by 2 is an improper fraction. Its reciprocal is minus 2 by 11, which is a proper fraction. So whenever you write reciprocals of the fraction, the reciprocal of proper fraction is improper fraction, and the reciprocal of improper fraction is proper fraction. That you have to observe. times. Now I am dividing 3 by 4 with 3. I am dividing a fraction with a whole number. So divide 3 by 4 with 3. A fraction is divided with a whole number. In that case, what we do? 3 by 4 into 1 by 3. I am writing the reciprocal of 3. The reciprocal of 3 is 1 by 3. The reciprocal of division is multiplication. Is equal to 3, 3 gets cancelled. The answer is 1 by 4. So you can observe it.
Okay, children, we are continuing. Now we take up 2 by 3 divided by 7. What is the divisor here? Dividend is 2 by 3. Reciprocal of division is multiplication, and the reciprocal of 7. 7 by no number means 1. So the reciprocal of 7 by 1 is 1 by 7. You observe any cancellation possible? No. So the product is 2 by 21. Now we are taking some examples. Divide 5 with 1 by 7. How we do it? 5 divided by 1 by 7 is the first step. Second step, dividend as it is. The reciprocal of division is into, and the reciprocal of 1 by 7 is 7 by 1. So the quotient equal to how much? 35. When 5 is divided with 1 by 7, the value of the quotient equal to 35. That means we multiplied with the reciprocal of the divisor. What is the divisor here? 1 by 7. What is its reciprocal? 7 by 1. Next, I am dividing a fraction with another fraction. Divide 3 by 7 with 14 by 9. So first step, 3 by 7 divided by 14 by 9 as it is. 3 by 7, the reciprocal of division is multiplication, and the reciprocal of 14 by 9 is 9 by 14. No cancellation possible here. 3 9s are 27 by 14 7s are 98. So the product of the two fractions is 27 by 98. Which is the quotient of 3 by 7 divided by 14 by 9. What is the divisor here? 14 by 9. What is its reciprocal? 9 by 14. So 3 by 7 into 9 by 14, no cancellation is possible. 3 9s are 27, 7 14s are 98. One more example. Divide 4 by 11 with 8 by 22. 8 by 22. 4 by 11 divided by 8 by 22 is the first step. 4 by 11 into 22 by 8. 11 ones, 11 twos. 4 ones, 4 twos. You got 2 by 2, which is equal to 1. So the division of 4 by 11 with 8 by 22 is nothing but 1. The final answer is 1. Multiply with the reciprocal of 8 by 22. Reciprocal of 8 by 22 is 22 by 8. You got 2 by 2, which is equal to 1. Next, 5 1 by 6 divided by 9 by 2. You observe 5 1 by 6 is a fraction, but it is a mixed fraction. First convert the fraction into improper. 6 5s are 30, 30 plus 1. 31 by 6 divided by 9 by 2. 31 by 6, the reciprocal of division is into, and the reciprocal of 9 by 2 is 2 by 9. 2 1s, 2 3s. Further cancellation is not possible. So 31 into 1, it is 31. By 3 into 9, it is 27. So the final product of these two is 31 by 27, or the quotient of 5 1 by 6 divided by 9 by 2 is 31 by 27. Next. Twelve divided by 3/4. First step as it is. 12 into reciprocal of 3/4 is 4/3. 3 ones, 3 fours. The final product is 16/1 or simply 16. Next one. 14 divided by 5/6. First step as it is. 14 into 6/5. Any cancellation possible? No. 14 6 are 84/5. This you can write as 16 4/5. Because 84/5 is an improper fraction, which you can write as a mixed fraction. Next one, 8 divided by 7/3. 8 into 3/7. Any cancellation possible? No. 8 threes are 24/7, which is equal to 3 3/7. If you write the mixed form of 24/7, it is 3 3/7. I think you followed this. So we are dividing a whole number with a fraction. Next, 4 divided by 8/3. 4 into 3/8. 4 ones, 4 twos, cancellation is possible. So numerator is remaining 3, denominator remaining 2. So the quotient of 4 divided by 8/3 is 3/2. Next one, 3 divided by 2 1/3. 3 divided by 3 twos are 6, 6 plus 1, 7/3. 3 into the reciprocal of 7/3 is 3/7. And you get 9/7, which you can write as 1 2/7. So the quotient when a whole number 3 is divided with a mixed fraction 2 1/3 is 1 2/7. First you convert 2 1/3 into improper fraction, which is 7/3. So 3 divided by 7/3 is equal to 3 into 3/7. The reciprocal of 7/3 is 3/7. So in the division process of fractions, you have to remember what is the reciprocal of the divisor. That gives us the correct answer. If you take the correct reciprocal, then the product is very easy to find. Next, write the reciprocals of the following. What is the reciprocal of 3/7? Reciprocal of 3/7 is 7/3. First one, reciprocals. Reciprocals of the given fractions. Second one, 5/8. What is the reciprocal of 5/8? 8/5. Third one, reciprocal of 9/7 is 7/9. Fourth one, reciprocal of 6/5 is 5/6. Fifth one, reciprocal of 12/7 is 7/12. Sixth one, reciprocal of 1/8 is 8/1 or simply 8. Reciprocal of 1/11, seventh one, is 11/1 or simply 11. Here you observe, 3/7 is a proper fraction. Its reciprocal 7/3 is improper. 9/7 is a improper fraction. Its reciprocal is proper fraction. 12/7 is improper fraction. Its reciprocal is proper fraction. 5/8 is proper fraction, reciprocal is improper fraction. 6/5 is improper fraction, reciprocal is proper fraction. 1/8 is a proper fraction, its reciprocal is a whole number. Reciprocal is a whole number. 1/11 is a proper fraction, its reciprocal is whole number. So in general, the reciprocal of proper fraction is improper fraction, and the reciprocal of improper fraction is proper fraction, and sometimes the reciprocal of proper fractions may be whole numbers. Now we are going to do some more problems. 7/3 divided by 2. That means you are dividing a fraction with a whole number. So how can you write the divisor as it is 7 by 3? Reciprocal of division is multiplication, and the reciprocal of 2 is 1 by 2. 2 by no number means 1. It is a whole number. You can write it as 2 by 1. So 7 by 3 into 1 by 2. Any cancellation possible? So take the product of the numerator. 7 into 1 it is 7. Take the product of the denominator. 3 into 2 it is 6. So the quotient when 7 by 3 divided by 2 is 7 by 6. We take up another one. 4 by 9 divided by 5. 4 by 9 into 1 by 5. The reciprocal of division is into, the reciprocal of 5 is 1 by 5. So 4 ones are 4 by 9 5s are 45. So the quotient is 4 by 45. Next. Six by 13 divided by 7. 6 by 13 into 1 by 7. So the product is 6 ones are 6 by 13 7s are 91. Next. 4 1 by 3 divided by 3. 3 4s are 12, 12 plus 1. 13 by 3 into the reciprocal of 3 is 1 by 3. So 13 ones are 13 by 3, 3s are 9. And this you again you can write as 9 ones 9, 1 4 by 9. 1 4 by 9 is the mixed fraction. 3 1 by 2 divided by 4 is equal to 2 3s are 6, 6 plus 1, 7 by 2 into 1 by 4. So the answer is 7 by 8. Last one, 4 3 by 7 divided by 7. 7 4s are 28, 28 plus 3, 31 by 7 into 1 by 7. 31 ones are 31 by 7 sevens are 49. In all these cases, we divided a fraction with a whole number. Next. Two by five divided by 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 5. The reciprocal of division is multiplication. Reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2 by 1, which is equal to 4 by 5. This is the first one in this model. Second one, 4 by 9 divided by 2 by 3. Here we are dividing a fraction with another fraction. 4 by 9 divided by 2 by 3 equal to 4 by 9 into 3 by 2. 2 1s, 2 2s, 3 1s, 3 3s. 2 1s are 2 by 3 1s are 3. So the final answer is 2 by 3. Third one, 3 by 7 divided by 8 by 7. Is equal to 3 by 7 into 7 by 8. Here 7 7 cancels, the final answer is 3 by 8. Fourth one, 2 1 by 3 divided by 3 by 5. 3 2s are 6, 6 plus 1, 7 by 3 into 3 by 5 you can write as 5 by 3. Any cancellation possible? No. So 7 into 5, it is 35 by 3 into 3, it is 9. 9 3s are 27. 35 minus 27, 8. 3 8 by 9. 9 3s are 27. 27 plus 8, 35 by 9 is an improper fraction which you can represent as a mixed fraction. Next. 3 1 by 2 divided by 8 by 3. 2 3s are 6, 6 plus 1, 7 by 2 into 3 by 8. Any cancellation possible? No. So take the product of the numerator. 7 3s are 21 by 2 8s are 16, which is equal to 1 5 by 16. The mixed fraction form of 21 by 16 is 1 5 by 16. Next one, 2 by 5 divided by 1 1 by 2. 2/5 divided by 1/1/2. 2/5 into improper form, 3/2. 2/5 into 2/3. So the final product is 4/15. And one more problem. 3 1/5 divided by 1 2/3. 5 3s are 15, 15 plus 1 16/5. Divided by 3 1s are 3, 3 plus 2 5/3 is equal to 16/5 into 3/5. No cancellation possible. 16 3s are 48/25. 1 23/25. Next, last one. 2 1/5. Next problem. 2 1/5 divided by 1 1/5. 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 1 11/5. Divided by 5 1s are 5, 5 plus 1 6/5 is equal to 11/5 into 5/6. Here 5 and 5 gets cancels. You got 11/6 is equal to 1 5/6. This is the final answer. So like this, we can divide a whole number with a fraction, or a fraction with a whole number, or a fraction with fractions. So like this, we can understand the process of division of fractions. Division of fractions is nothing but multiplying with the reciprocal of the divisor. Reciprocals are what? Non-zero numbers whose product with the given fraction is equal to 1. Such numbers are called reciprocals. So with this, we conclude division of fractions, and next class we are going to continue decimal fractions. How fractions are converted into decimal form, that we are going to understand in the next class. Thank you, children. We continue in the next class.